Humans very much depend on the present. Everything we do in life is done with the understanding that we're doing it right now, whether we're hugging a friend or recording a YouTube video. We do it in the now and then it becomes the past. But it might surprise you to find out that in science, what we think of as the present doesn't actually exist. Only the past and the future do. When we look into the night sky, we are seeing the past, often the distant past. If you look at the Andromeda Galaxy, which is just barely visible to the naked eye in a dark location, you are seeing it as it was 2.5 million years ago because light travels at a rate of 186,000 miles per second, and it takes that long to travel the immense distance between the two galaxies. This is also true for an object in the room with you. When you look at your phone, you are seeing it as it was a tiny fraction of a second ago, not as it is right now. Light, or information, takes time to propagate no matter the distance. This means that in any direction you look, you are always seeing the past, no matter what. You are not seeing the now. In fact, it's physically impossible for you to see the now. But it gets worse. It's also impossible for the now to exist in your brain because it also takes time for impulses to travel along neurons, and this doesn't happen at the same rate for everyone. All of our brains are unique. Each human brain varies in the time it takes to process the information it receives from the outside world. This means that your now is different from my now, even if just by a fraction of a second. Perception is a deep rabbit hole indeed because the differences between brains covers more than just processing time. Diagnosable conditions like color blindness aside, you probably do not see the same colors that I do. How you perceive red is likely different from how I perceive it, but since there's no way to describe the color red, then there's no way to know, at least until brain-to-brain interfaces become available. Likewise, you don't experience the present at the same time that I do. The difference is minuscule, a matter of milliseconds, but it's there. Intuitively, we think of the present like a sandwich filling. It's wedged between the past and the future. But in reality, it's not. It's actually a completely fake construct of our brain. You can see this by thinking about what a moment in time really is. When you think about it, the present has no duration. There is no length of time involved. You're just conscious moving from one moment to the next seamlessly. We have to artificially make a duration for it with a clock. In other words, our perception of the present is just a construct of our brains. It doesn't really exist. Yet we live our entire lives in this strange juxtaposition of having memory of the past and expectation of the future, and are led to believe that we're in the present at all times by our brains. But what is time? If you think about it, keeping track of time is really just keeping track of change. If nothing ever changed, time would seem to have stopped. As a result, there would be no present because there would be no change from which to judge it. If nothing changed in your brains and your neurons simply stopped firing, i.e. stopped changing, the present would cease for you. So would consciousness. Are time and consciousness linked? In some ways, yes. At least our notion of time is. But does time really exist? Well, in some ways it does, and in some ways it doesn't. Time is thought to be a dimension, one that we always move forward in. We don't actually know why that is, but I'll leave that for a future video. If you're talking about time as we perceive it, then it doesn't appear to exist. But if we're talking about time in the sense of physics, it very much exists. And whatever it is, it's linked to space itself, hence space-time. It can speed up or slow down. It ticks at different rates depending on where you are as far as gravity is concerned and how fast you are moving. If you're just about to fall into a black hole, then time nearly stops. For someone observing you. For you, it seems to tick normally. That's because everything is relative. That throws another wrench into the works of perception. That wrench is Einstein's theory of special relativity. Einstein realized that because everything is relative, two different observers will perceive events differently depending on where they are. For example, if you were in orbit watching the Earth below, you might see two train wrecks, one in Sweden and one in Argentina. To you, they appear to happen at exactly the same moment. But if you were at a different angle in orbit, they would appear to happen at slightly different times because of the change in distances the light has to travel. This is because the observation of events is relative to the distances and motion involved, and thusly the question of when they happened is also relative. One person believes the events were simultaneous because she observed them to be. The other does not because he observed them and saw something different. There is no such thing as an absolute frame of reference. This whole idea gets even stranger when you dig into philosophy. If the present doesn't exist and the past is that which already happened and the future is that which has not yet happened, then where exactly are we? If you've watched my video, Is the Universe Real or Is it a Computer Simulation?, you'll know that the universe essentially doesn't exist if you aren't looking at it. If you remove intuitive notions of time and space, that idea gets even more murky. There is no when, there is no is, there is only consciousness observing changes in space. That constitutes everything we experience from our birth to our death, but let's take it a step further. There is actually no way to prove that anything exists outside your own mind. The only thing you can prove to yourself is that you exist. Everything else could be an illusion. And when you alter perception just slightly, this becomes readily apparent. Mind-altering substances alter the brain's perceptions, and thusly things that do not exist for you and I do exist for the person under the influence. Someone on LSD may see a giant blue coyote doling out words of wisdom and completely believe that it's there, whereas the onlooker sees nothing. The person tripping can't prove that the coyote exists, but he certainly thinks it does, at least until the effects of the drug wear off. But that's a two-sided coin. A sober person also can't prove that what they are seeing is real to anyone else. This is because every piece of information you get comes from your senses. Senses can be fooled by fooling the brain or making it malfunction. This means that to get anywhere in life, you must assume that what you are seeing is real. And likewise, the rest of us have to assume the same thing. This means that existence itself is fundamentally based on an assumption. So that brings us back to the present. If the present isn't real, and the past is already gone, and the future isn't here yet, and perception is different for everyone, how does all of this manage to work? I have no idea. As Einstein said, people like us who believe in physics know that the distinction between past, present, and future is only a stubbornly persistent illusion. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently looking for some aspirin after pondering existence for a bit too long. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for in-depth regular explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.